So President Trump loves to point to the economy, specifically the stock market, as proof of his performance. And he says that the recent success is all because of him. His director of legislative affairs, Mark Short, took that case to the Sunday shows. Here's a sample.
There are a lot of people who said the president couldn't create 2 million jobs in the first year, who said we wouldn't see unemployment at a 17-year low, who said we wouldn't see GDP at 3%, who also said that after the tax relief package, in 1 month, 3.1 million Americans, 3.1 million workers have either received a pay increase or a bonus.
All right. Beautiful example. Let's take it point by point. The economy added 2 million jobs in 2017. Is that true? Yes. But that's not a great number. In fact, 2017 sticks out as a low point. Take a look at the facts. 2014, 3 million jobs. 2015, 2.7 million jobs. 2016, 2.2 million jobs. You notice how they're going down? That was expected. Why? Because you were coming off of a boosted recovery. And when you have long-term change like that, it is going to taper. So you certainly can't sell 2017's performance as anything earth-shattering. All right, next point. GDP growth, 3%. This is just not true. How do we know? The Bureau of Economic Analysis. The actual GDP, 2.3%. How does that line up? Average. Places 2017, 11th in GDP growth out of the last 20 years. All right, next point. 3 million Americans have either received a pay increase or a bonus, and it's all thanks to Trump's tax cut. This is more complex. Let's look at it this way. Some of the companies that boosted pay, let's look at Walmart. They did. They also laid off 8,000 workers right around the same time, according to Reuters. Comcast, another big company that was making headlines, granted $1,000 bonuses to 100,000 employees. But it did fire 500 of its managers across multiple states. AT&T, same thing. $1,000 bonuses to 200,000 employees, but 4,000 layoffs at the same time. And in one case, Wells Fargo breathlessly thanked Trump for his tax cut and for its wage hike, but then it flip-flopped on whether it was because of the tax cut or part of a pre-existing plan. What we need to know there is what percentage of the tax savings that these companies are getting are they then passing on to labor as opposed to shareholders? That'll be an important stat. When I get it, you'll get it. Unemployment, 17-year low, true, 4.1%. But remember this.
The phony unemployment rate. The unemployment rate is probably 20%.
They say 5.3% unemployment. The number's probably 32%.
When you hear 4.9 and 5% unemployment, the number's probably 28, 29, as high as 35.
You know what? I agree with the president. Every economist would. Why? Because he's referring to what is a little bit of a deception when it comes to unemployment. All right? And Christine Romans is so good on this. If you do a Google search, she lays it out so well. He's really talking about the U6 underemployment, temp workers who don't, yes, they're working, but they have less hours, less money. The work market has shifted. So to just look at this one unemployment factor is often misleading. All right? So he was right about that, but now he's owning it. It's so interesting. Every White House, for as long as we can remember, says we're responsible for everything that we get. But when Obama did that, Trump said the numbers were phony. Now he's using the same numbers, making the same case. I thought he was supposed to be different. Economists say this level of unemployment, okay, what we see with this level of unemployment versus the wage growth, which is 2.5%, it's not where it should be. Wages should be going up more. That's what we focus on. Not just Wall Street, Main Street. Those are the facts.